Just you and me, it's so wonderful. we are gathered here today in the sight of God and in the presence of these witnesses to join together this man and this woman in holy matrimony, which is an honorable estate instituted by God in the time of humanity, innocent signifying to us the mythical union which is between Christ and his church, which holy estate. Christ adorned and beautified with this his presence, the first miracle that he wrought at Cana of Galilee, and is commanded of St. Paul to be honorable among all men, therefore not by any to be entered upon or taken into hand unadvisedly, but reverently, discreetly, advisedly, and in the fear of God, into which holy estate these persons come now to be joined. Therefore, if any man can show any just cause why they may not be lawfully joined together, let them now speak, or else hereafter and forever hold their peace. I require and charge you both, as you will answer at the dreadful day of the judgment, when the secret of all hearts shall be disclosed, that if either of you know any impediment why you may not be lawfully joined together in matrimony, you do now confess it. For if you be well assured that so many are coupled together otherwise than God's word shall allow, are not joined together by God, neither in their matrimony. Who giveth this woman away?
Her father, I do.
To be thy wedded wife, to live together after God's ordinance, in the holy estate of matrimony. Will thou love her, comfort her, honor and keep her, in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep thee only unto her as long as you both shall live?
Yes.
Vandrea, will thou have this man to be thy wedded husband, to live together after God's ordinance, in the holy estate of matrimony? Will thou serve him, love him, honor and keep him, in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep thee only unto him so long as you shall live? Carl, will you take her right hand? Carl, take thee, Vandy, to be my wedded wife.
Yes.
To have and to hold, from this day forward, for better for worse, for richer for poorer, in sickness and in health. To love, cherish, till death do us part. According to God's holy ordinance. thereto I plight thy faith.